Welcome to Back to the Bible. You are listening to Strength for the Journey, a daily devotional by Theodore Epp.
October 10th, Learning to Love. Ephesians chapter 5, verses 1 to 5. Does the standard of God's love seem too high to attain? Having received Jesus Christ as Savior, we have been born of the Holy Spirit and have become members of God's family. We have become partakers in or sharers of the divine nature. 2 Peter chapter 1 verses 4. And the essence of the divine nature is love. It is the kind of love that loves even when there is no response, always seeking the highest good for the other person. That God loved us when there was no response is evident from Romans chapter 5 verses 8. But God commanded his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. But it can be said that because of our having received Jesus Christ as Savior, the love of God is now shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost which is given unto us. Verses 5. Since it is His love that is in our hearts, we are able to attain God's standard of love by letting Christ live His life in us as He desires. The expression of this love in us is one of the strongest proofs that we really are the children of God. 1 John chapter 4 verses 7 to 16. When Paul urged believers to walk in love, Ephesians chapter 5 verses 2, he was emphasizing that our life is lived one step at a time. As we rely on the Lord for the step we are now taking, we need not worry about the steps that are ahead. Of course, Paul was referring to a person's way of life. 1 John chapter 3 verses 18 says, "My little children, let us not love in word, neither in tongue, but in deed and in truth. It is easy to talk, but it is costly to walk. A new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another as I have loved you, that ye also love one another." John chapter 13 verses 34. Amen.
Back to the Bible, leading people into a dynamic relationship with God.